Morning, good afternoon, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, depending on where in the globe you're joining us from. Dear friends, colleagues, and distinguished members of the film fraternity, welcome to the first ever online meet of Locations Connect Live. I'm Hugo D'Souza, your host for the day. In the past 8 years, we've served you well by bringing to India hundreds of film commissions, tourism offices, and production service companies from over 50 countries at our award-winning film locations show, IIFTC Conclave, consistently working towards our mission of creating a bridge between global film locations and the Indian film industry. We have pioneered many concepts during this journey, be it our large format flagship event, IIFTC Conclave in Mumbai, or our intimate IIFTC roundtable events in cities across India, or India's first and premier Films Locations Guide, Cineport Magazine, or our unique IIFTC Tourism Impact Awards, recognizing the contribution of Indian films to the global tourism industry. In the post-COVID-19 world, we are proud to present to you yet another platform, locationsconnect.com, which is an online marketplace for Indian filmmakers and content producers to discover locations from around the world, establish connect with locations, stakeholders, and service providers. Today marks the launch of this online venture through this webinar, featuring three fascinating film destinations, the Philippines, Portugal, and Kenya. In the next 90 minutes, we will hear from the film commissions and production services companies from these countries as they share with us their stunning film locations, film incentive policy, post-COVID-19 protocols, and any other information that you may seek. Our first session of the day is Country Showcase, where we'll have film commissions from the Philippines and Portugal making a presentation each on the policy aspects. This will be followed by the next session, Production Showcase, where we have two very experienced companies from Kenya and Portugal talking about the practical aspects of the business. But before we start the proceedings of the day, I would like to invite to set the tone for Locations Connect the man behind this venture, founder of IIFTC Conclave and director of Europa Media and Entertainment, Harshad Bhagwat. Harshad, over to you.
Thank you, Hugo, for that wonderful introduction, and welcome everybody to the first edition of Locations Connect Live. About a year ago, on 7th of March 2020, we had the last event of IIFTC Conclave in Mumbai. And everyone told me that I was so lucky to beat the pandemic, and we were perhaps the last major entertainment event in Mumbai, or in India for that matter, before the lockdown started. Now I realize 13 months later how wrong I was. I would have never imagined meeting all of you through this new media, but perhaps something good has come out of this whole thing is our new venture, which is called locationsconnect.com. We have revamped our website. It has information from film locations and service providers from over 50 countries. The website is designed as a marketplace where buyers and sellers can meet each other and conduct business. So I would request all the members of the audience to have a look at our website, locationsconnect.com. Coming back to today's session, Hugo, with your permission, I would like to break the norm and thank you people before we begin the session. I see many familiar faces from friends and colleagues from the industry. I know these are trying times. The pandemic in Mumbai is growing. The numbers are, going out of control. But I would like to thank all of you for taking your time out and being present here today to listen to all our speakers and panelists. The idea of Locations Connect Live came about a month ago when we approached a few of our select clients. My friend Lisa Dino, who I think has just joined in, ever energetic and charismatic film commissioner of Philippines. She was the first to jump aboard. So thank you, Lisa, for trusting us. I would like to thank my friends Manuel Claro of Portugal Film Commission, Jim and Hemal, who are here from Africa, from Kenya, JP from all around globe. Thank you, all of us, for being a part of this webinar and agreeing to be our speakers today. I would like to thank our hospitality partner, Taj Santa Cruz, who have some surprises in store for us. The convener of IIFTC, Mr. Anindya Das Gupta, who's here. And last but not the least, my team, Hemal, Sheetal, Felicia, and Adesh, for putting this event together. So without further ado, let the show begin.
Thank you, Harshad. Thank you for that warm and cordial welcome and for so beautifully setting the tone for our webinar ahead. Before we begin the first session of the day, I have a couple of important announcements to make. There will be a Q&A round at the end of each session, and I shall request all the audience members to share their questions with the moderator in the chat box with your name and the name of your company. We shall compile all these questions that you send in and put them to our presenters at the end of each session. And two, and very excitingly, we're going to have a lucky draw at the end of today's program. We have exciting staycation vouchers, courtesy of hospitality partner Taj Hotels at their stunning new property in Santa Cruz, Mumbai. All the members of the film fraternity from India and present at the end of the seminar, you have to be present at the end of the seminar, will qualify for the lucky draw. So hold on to your seats and let the show begin. The Philippines is defined by its emerald rice fields, teeming megacities, graffiti-splashed jeepneys, smoldering volcanoes, bug-eyed tarsiers, fuzzy water buffalo, and smiling, happy-go-lucky people. This tropical country in the Pacific Ocean is blessed with beautiful natural landscapes and an abundance of beautiful beaches. That's hardly a surprise, as the Philippines is made up of a jaw-dropping 7,000 plus islands, making it one of the largest archipelagos in the world. Spanish colonial pockets of Manila, pristine beaches of Boracay, the diverse paradise of Cebu, or the volcanic island of Tegete in the middle of Taal Lake. There's a lot to explore for filmmakers who seek adventure, nature, and a unique culture. To tell us more about this magical country, we have the Film Development Council of Philippines, also known as FDCP. FDCP is responsible for film policies and programs to ensure the economics, cultural, and educational development of the Philippine film industry. FDCP is represented at locations connected by Ms. Lisa Dino, Undersecretary and Chairperson and Chief Executive Officer, FDCP, and Ms. Agathe Vinson, Technical Consultant to Film Philippines. Over to Lisa Dino.
Good evening, colleagues and friends from the world cinema. My name is Undersecretary Lisa Dino of the Film Development Council of the Philippines, and I am delighted to enjoy an audience with you tonight. We've always looked up to India as a country of enormous talent and resources, with the distinction of having the world's largest film industry. The India International Film Tourism Conclave, or IIFTC, is a time-honored tradition of connecting the world's producers, filmmakers, film commissions, and production companies with India and its cinema players and platforms from all over the world. In this unprecedented pandemic, much of the world found itself in situations where production has become so difficult and challenging. Never in the history of world cinema has there been a most opportune time for collaboration and cooperation than now. We applaud the efforts of the IIFTC to commence with this gathering and continue to find ways of how we can all create, work, and watch together. The Philippines is one of the countries that have resumed productions amid this pandemic, thanks to our government support in providing us the policies that give us leeway to continue producing with relative safety and confidence. Our Indian and international content creators here would be happy to know that the Philippines is open for filming and business and new offerings for all to explore. Anyone who has been to the Philippines will know and remember the beautiful beaches, the diverse natural features of forests, mountains, deserts, and of course, our generous, pleasant, and very skilled people. They're all still here. And in the last 2 years, the FDCP has welcomed close to a dozen international projects which have enjoined our very new Film Philippines incentives. One of those incentives is the 20% cash rebate for all qualified production spending in the Philippines for qualified foreign productions that shoot and produce here. This is the Film Location Incentive Program, or FLIP, and a little later, my colleague Agathe Vinson will give you the precise details on how to apply and take advantage of this initiative. We know how important ease of business is, and production is for you. And this is what our Film Location Engagement Desk, or FLEX, is all about. FLEX affords foreign productions with general assistance with government permits and transactions, including special work permits for foreign casts and crew, tax-free importation of equipment and assets, location permits for cities across the country, road traffic management, and safety and security protocols, and other important aspects of filming in the Philippines. FLEX can also help you connect with duly registered Filipino line producers, actors, creative and technical professionals towards an efficient and cost-effective production in our country. Our National Registry Database gives you direct access to the current listing of cinematographers, production designers, actors, creative producers, post-production and VFX companies, or anyone else you may need for producing your project in the Philippines. As the pandemic hopefully dissipates and businesses resume their normal runs, we expect our producers to resume and ramp up their productions. And we hope that you can be part of the action. While we place health and safety above all, we are committed to working with you as consummately as we can. With the help of our FDCP Safe Filming Program that allows productions to continue filming with the guidance of safety and health protocols. In October 2019, there was a culture exchange program between the National Commission for Culture and the Arts of the Government of the Philippines and the Ministry of Culture of the Government of India. This memorandum of agreement on this was signed during the official visit of the Republic of India's President, His Excellency Ram Nath Kovind. And this agreement covered cooperation on culture and the arts, including film and archives. This comes into mind right now as we imagine the exciting prospects of working with India in the field of cinema. I remember that the FDCP is part of the final draft of the co-production treaty between India and the Philippines, and I hope that this treaty will be finalized and come into fruition very, very soon. The rest of the bright possibilities you can find in the Philippines, I will leave to my esteemed colleagues to expound on. For now, please enjoy the sights and sounds of our locations and our cinema. And we hope to see you all soon as we create together. As we create cinema together, we create reality shows together, we create animation together, and many, many more. Let me cap this message with an introduction to a video discussing the 10 fantastic reasons to shoot in the Philippines. Please watch this.
From nature-filled provinces to bustling cities, the Philippines has what it takes to be a great film location for your projects. Without sacrificing required quality standards, the Philippines offers a broad selection of cost-efficient equipment and facilities for your filming needs.
From a financial point of view, the Philippines is very attractive because things tend to be less expensive across the board. There's a great opportunity here.
The National Registry holds the database for all active film and television staff, audiovisual businesses, audiovisual organizations, and film festivals in the Philippines. It opens opportunities and promotes the local audiovisual industry to the world market.
Come over here. Use our crew, use our staff,
use our production people, production equipment, use our actors. You won't be disappointed.
Creative, talented, hospitable, honest, respectful, resourceful, hardworking, passionate, and cheerful. That's how Filipinos are. And you can be assured that the Filipinos' ingenuity and flexibility will be an ease for you to work with.
The work ethic is really, really great. People are, they learn fast. They are moving fast. You've got this plethora, if you will, of talent. You know what I mean? And so you don't have to look any further. We're not shipping anybody in. I don't think anyone's come in from the United States yet because we've got all the talent we need here. It's been a pleasure filming here.
The Philippines is recognized globally as one of the largest English-speaking nations, with the majority of its population having at least some degree of fluency in the language. English has always been one of the official languages of the Philippines and is spoken by more than 14 million Filipinos. And the audiovisual crew are no exception. What more can you ask for? Safety is paramount, and it should always be kept in mind. Therefore, safe filming is a must. From pre-production to post-production, the Film Philippines office offers incentives options for your production aspirations in the Philippines. To discuss this program, here is Ms. Agath Vinson, technical consultant of the Film Philippines office of the Film Development Council of the Philippines.
Be the Film Location Incentive Program, aka FLIP, which is a 20% cash rebate on your project's eligible Philippine expenses, capped for now, at 10 million pesos. So for those one, you have cycle of application, 3 per year, each one of 3 months. So basically you can apply 9 months per year. So no hurry, you will have 3 different slots throughout the year to apply it with your project. So the first cycle is the one from January to March. Then we're closing for a month in order for us to organize the selective committee. Then second cycle from May to July, with the selection committee in August, and the third cycle of the year, and last one, the September to November. So as you can say, we're currently in approaching the end of cycle one. Eligible applicant for FLIP will be your Filipino line producer. Line producer can be a production line producing company, a post-production company, as well as, for example, an animation studio. This local company needs to be accredited by our FDCP National Registry. It's our national database of all the film companies. You can see all the FDCP National Registry accredited companies on the National Registry website. As per the eligible format, FLIP is open to basically all audiovisual content from feature film and short film of live action, IMAX, documentary, animation, to TV and VOD content, reality show series unit, web content, music video, and of course, even virtual reality content. So far, only commercials are not eligible. The main requirement for FLIP is an extremely low minimum eligible spending in the Philippines of 8 million pesos, currently approximately 150,000 USD. So in your application, you will have to show that you at least have this minimum spending planning in the Philippines to submit your application and hopefully be selected. How is the application process working? And you're going to see our other incentive program have a bit of the same pattern here. So you start by, of course, be in touch with the Film Philippine office, our amazing team. We can discuss all of this in details of your project. Then you will download all the application materials on our website and apply for provisional application. Then we're going to review your application. You're going to go through one of our committee and 1 point. If you're selected, finger crossed, you're going to receive a provisional certificate notification. Then you'll have to start actually spending in the Philippines within 6 months, which means it's important not to apply too early or too late. Within 6 months, you start shooting in the Philippines, doing post-production in the Philippines, VFX, animation work, again. Once you're done spending in the Philippines for your project, then you will apply to the final verification. And when I'm saying you, it's mainly your Filipino partner. He's the contact person for FDCP. He's the one applying directly with us for the provisional application until the final verification. Of course, he will need to coordinate a lot with you as a foreign partner. You submit, of course, all the receipts, all the invoices. It goes through the audit department, and after the final approval, the Filipino line producer will receive the 20% cash rebate based on those audited eligible expenses. ICOF. It's a selective fund for international co-production with the Philippines, with a cap of 10 million pesos. So again, 10 million pesos would be 200,000 USD. The application cycle are exactly the same as FLIP, so 3 cycles per year. Cycle first from January to March, second from May to July, and third from September to November. Eligible applicants are still the production, the Filipino production, in that case, co-producer, accredited also from the FDCP National Registry. And the eligible format are only feature film of live action, IMAX, documentary, and animation. No series, no short films. The main requirement for ICOF is a minimum spending of 5 million, so approximately 98,000 USD, to be spent again in eligible, what we call QPPE, qualifying production Philippine expenditures. The application process, very similar, with one and very big difference. When you start your provisional application, when you're arriving at the second stage here, where your project is selected and you receive your notification, then even at that stage, you're going to receive the fund amount and a 50% down payment of it. Then you can start your production. At the end of it, again, your Filipino co-producer will apply for final verification. And after this final verification, you're going to receive the remaining 50% of the fund. So it will really help you to cash flow your production. Our brand new ASEAN co-production fund, we just launched this one in January this year. So it's a selective fund, once more, for ASEAN co-production with the Philippines, capped at 150,000 USD. Application cycle, once more, exactly the same, 3 cycles per year. An eligible applicant, again, the Filipino production company, in that case, the Filipino co-producer, partnering with an ASEAN production, again, accredited by the FDCP National Registry. Just to give you an idea, as per March 2020, the list of ASEAN countries were Indonesia, Malaysia, Philippines, Singapore, Thailand, Brunei, Vietnam, Laos, Myanmar, Cambodia, and East Timor. It's important to, I would like to remind you now that ICOF and ACOF are both open for minority or minority production with the Philippines. So it can be either a Filipino project, co-producing with, in case for the International Co-Production Fund, a foreign production company or a foreign project co-producing with the Philippines. It's going to be the same for the ASEAN Co-Production Fund. The project can be led by an ASEAN company and be co-produced with the Philippines or the opposite. Eligible format, once more, only feature film of live action, IMAX documentary and animation. We also updated the fact that now they are open for any type of exhibition platform, again, because we know that theatrical release were not possible through basically almost now a year. Now we are almost celebrating a year. So it's open also for on-demand video, for example, released. And for this one, we will need for the director to be from an ASEAN nationality, including the Philippines. The requirements for this one will be to spend 50% of the fund granted into the qualifying production Philippine expenditures. And once more, if you need more details on the eligible expenses, you'll find the detail within the guidelines. Just to give you a heads up, they are quite nice because they're open from expenses from development, pre-production, production, post-production, all expenses spent in the Philippines, of course. Application process, exactly the same as the International Co-Production Fund. You apply, once you're selected, you receive the fund amount and a 50% down payment of it. Then you start your production in the Philippines. Once you're done spending in the Philippines, you submit the final verification. And at the end of that, you will receive the 50% final payment of your fund.
The Film Location Engagement Desk, or FLEX, provides ease of doing business by offering assistance for government permits, locations, and production logistics in the Philippines. Here again is Ms. Agathe Vincent to discuss what you need to know about this one-stop shop.
It's a one-stop shop assistance program that you can benefit it from free. It's a free and automatic application open for foreign project as well as a Filipino project. So through this program, you can apply all year long, so there is no cycle of application, and you can benefit from an inter-agency government assistance. So basically, the FDCP can endorse your project and then put you in contact and facilitate all the communication with other LGUs, which are local government unit here in the Philippines, or other governmental agencies. So applicants can be either a local or a foreign production company, of course, aiming to film in the Philippines. An eligible project, foreign or Filipino audiovisual content. The main requirement is to apply 2 months before start actually shooting, or if it's even pre-production, or if it's just for post-production, before your project. Those 2 months are extremely important to allow us to coordinate with all those other governmental agencies so that everything can run smoothly. Here is the overview of the type of services, the type of services we are providing through the FLEX program. We can help you finding your partner, a co-producer within the Philippines, a line production company, an animation studio, you name it, we probably have it. A location scouting, sourcing of skilled cast and crew, sourcing of equipment technical facility, as well as securing visa and special working permits, extremely important once more, specifically now that we have, we need for some of you exemption to enter in the Philippines. That is something that through the FLEX application, the Film Philippine office can help and support. Obtaining location permits as well, production logistics, special government production assets, conditionally free importation and exportation, as well as, again, extremely important those days, implementing health and safety protocols. So that is just a very short overview of everything you can avail through the FLEX program.
In 2020, FDCP and FPO awarded the two financial incentives for the first time. Here are the projects who received our support.
Thank you to Ms. Lisa Dino and Ms. Agathe Vincent and the FDCP for that captivating presentation. Keep your questions for the FDPC team coming in the chat box as we move on from the exotic Philippines to enthralling Portugal. Medieval castles, cobblestone villages, captivating cities and golden beaches. The Portugal experience can be many, many things. History, great food and idyllic scenery are just the beginning. This oldest country of Europe is full of wonders and home to some of the most exotic destinations pristine beaches, and a metropolitan splattered with remnants of the past. Its Mediterranean charm is most prominent on the golden beaches of the Algarve, in the wilderness of the Azores Islands, among the vineyards of Douro Valley, and on the cobbled streets of Lisbon and Porto, where old world culture meets cosmopolitan bars and restaurants. Portugal is the ultimate filmmaker's paradise. To tell us more about this captivating country, we have the Portugal Film Commission, which is a part of the Portuguese government's project group that supports tourism and cinema, with its main objective of promoting the cinema and audiovisual industry and promoting Portugal as a filming destination. The Portugal Film Commission is represented by the film commissioner himself, Mr. Manuel Claro, who made quite an impression at the IAFTC Conclave 2020 at a lively panel discussion with renowned filmmaker Imtiaz Ali. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Manuel Claro.
Thank you, Hugo, for your presentation, and thank you all for attending this session. Welcome to all of you, and it's for us a big pleasure to be here attending this IIFTC Location Connect Live. My name is Manuel Claro. I'm the Film Commissioner at the Portugal Film Commission, and it's a real pleasure to be here today. Last year, the Portugal Film Commission had the chance to be present at the Conclave in Mumbai, and of course, we are very much looking forward to attending the Conclave physically again next year. Allow me to share my screen and my presentation, please. Just give me. I hope that now you are watching my screen.
Yes. Okay,
perfect. Just to be aware of the time, okay. But before I start, let me also share to you a little bit of the context of Portugal and the path that we made until we get here. So Portugal is a small country at the very west side of Europe, inhabited by 10 million of resilient and strong people that love to host, to receive people from other cultures, other countries, other nationalities. So we realized that we should have as a national purpose the investment of the investment in the promotion of the country abroad. In order to attract people via tourism and also foreign investment into our country. So we realized that you can't skip us, that you can't skip Portugal. So I invite you all to watch a short video. Please have a look.
How many times have you left early, cancelled a meeting, or otherwise changed your plan?
How many times do you find yourself staying when you say you're going?
How many times have you thought about starting over, but said to yourself, well, perhaps I'm a stayer, not a goer?
How many times did you look at yourself from another perspective and grasp, when all was said and done, you were simply in the wrong place?
This is the moment to seek out new views and angles.
We're the same size as what we see and not what we have.
We may not all speak the same language, but we do all speak with the same tongue.
The good news is they are still here. These landscapes do persist in the three-dimensional world that we exist, and they do hold the capacity to transform us. So come, take a look, but look to see and not to show, and save it right here and here. Put the phone away and go.
Don't feel like you're past your best. Just remember that no matter how many years we are granted, and however wise, however much dust has settled in our eyes, We still don't know just what wave might be next. 2 meter roller or a 30 meter breaker?
Escaping is pointless.
So voyage out, let the wind blow through your sails. Explore, dream, and discover. Believe that that sky is going to seem that bit bluer.
It's not the time to take your bow. Past is behind, the future ahead. What we have is this great moment now.
Keep this in your head. It's the truth. And this is the proof. And it's with us each and every day. We just have to read the signs.
The train only passes once. We can't skip new ideas.
We can't skip new beginnings.
Because after all, we can't skip life.
So under this purpose, this national purpose of Can't Skip Portugal, we also realized that we should promote the country through different sectors. And we were during the last years observing how the other countries, the big ones, were working as far as film caption is concerned, attraction of film for their territories. And we thought that we should create not one more tax incentive, but we should create one of the most competitive cash rebate systems. And we created the Portuguese cash rebate system in September 2018, about which I will talk a bit more in detail in a couple of minutes. And with the mission of better promote the cash rebates and of course the country as a film filming destination, Portugal created in June 2019 the Portugal Film Commission, and here we are. And I would like to introduce you to my wonderful team, Sandra Neves, the executive director, and Sandra and I, we have the privilege to count with three amazing project officers, Ana Cabeças, Filipa Magalhães, and Margarida Silva. We are all here in these small squares of on your screen. We are attending this session when we will all be delighted to answer all the questions you may have after this presentation in the Q&A, or even afterwards via email or through our website, portugalfilmcommission.com, or even through our social media. It's very funny because I would like to send our greetings to the Philippines Film Office, because it's really we are getting used to do this together after the Berlinale, the European Film Market, and we are again together here presenting our project. So it's also for us a big pleasure to share this presentation with the Philippines. At the Portugal Film Commission, we have three main goals: to promote Portugal as a filming destination at the international level, that's what I'm trying to do now; to facilitate the whole process of filming in Portugal; and to create and promote synergies between the governmental areas in order to reach the first two goals, and in order to reach a film-friendly environment in our country. We also have many good reasons to film in Portugal, but we chose 11 reasons to film in Portugal, not only to have one more than Philippines, but which was 11 reasons to shoot in Portugal. First of all, of course, the sunny days. As you can imagine, Portugal, we have around 300 sunny days per year. We have a huge variety of locations. We have history, we have culture, breathtaking landscapes, diversity of beaches, year-round activities, diversity of hotels. So we have a huge amount of different scenarios, and of course, and especially in a very accessible way. So our country is a small country. You can travel by from the north to the south by car in less than 5 hours. So you can find diversity at a very short distance. And you can count in Portugal also with experienced, hardworking professionals. So the quality of our talent and technical crews are really high. Our professionals are few, and you can find experienced professionals and high quality of artistic and technical crews. We are also able to provide some studio facilities and equipment, especially around the two big cities of Portugal, Porto and Lisbon, and also the Algarve region. Affordable costs and great food, as you know, and as Hugo mentioned before. We are also a safe country. We are the third safest country in the world, as per the Global Peace Index. We have a very good quality healthcare system, and especially a universal healthcare system that nowadays it's very it's also very important. Co-production agreements with more than 50 countries or 60 countries. And we have our co-production treaty signed with India in March 2020. So it's available now, our co-production treaty with India. Here you can see the map. Of course, the cash rebate and also the scouting program. I would like to share also some images of some locations, just to give you a little bit the tone of our country. As you can see, you can find many different scenarios in Portugal, and as I said before, in a, at a very short distance. And I would like also to share with you a short video of a cinematographer's journey, and you can see that it's very easy to reach many different scenarios in 24 hours. Please have a look. Thank you. But of course, Portugal is much more than beautiful locations, and it's much more than landscape. So we are also able to offer you a wide set of financial instruments, and I would like to talk a bit more about them now. So we have the cash rebate. The Portuguese cash rebate is our celebrity as far as the film attraction to our territory. The Portuguese Minority Co-Production Scheme offered by ICA, the Portuguese Speaking Countries Scheme also offered by ICA. ICA is our ICA, it's our National Film Institute, Instituto do Cinema e do Audiovisual. We are also able to offer some bilateral funds, especially with France, Italy, Luxembourg, and we are under negotiations with other countries also. Portugal is a participant country at several supranational funds, for example, the Creative Europe Media of the European the European Union, the Ibermedia Fund, the Eurimais Fund, and we have in Portugal two special credit lines of two of the most important Portuguese banks that are also funded by the Creative Europe program via European Investment Fund, specially dedicated to SMEs of cultural and creative sectors, and that offers special conditions as far as access to finance is concerned. So it's also a good thing to know. Portugal created one of the most competitive incentive systems in Europe, a cash rebate, funded by the Tourism Board. It applies for film, TV, and VOD projects with a minimum qualified Portuguese production expenses, QPPE, of half a million euros, around $600,000 for fiction and animation, and €250,000, around $300,000 for documentaries and post-production projects. It's for films, TV and VOD productions, national or foreign production, line, producers, services, film, or also official co-productions or de facto co-production. So you have all these options. The incentive is 25 or 30% rebate rate of the QPPE and is determined by a cultural test that focus on project characteristics. You also have some limits in terms of the above the line, and it's always 30% for projects of cultural with cultural relevance, high impact on Portuguese cinematography, and with high economic impact in Portugal, with expenses in low density territories, costs with actors and technicians with disabilities. In all those cases, it's 30%. But let me also share with you that until now we have 76 projects already approved since the beginning of the cash rebate, and all of them reached the 30% rebate rate. So it's relatively easy to reach the 30% with our cultural test. It's in a first come, first serve basis. The maximum cap per project is 4 million euros, so around 5 million US dollars. And we have, I think, the two main features that places our cash rebate as one of the most competitive systems in Europe is that we have upfront payments in installments, that it's quite useful even for the cash flow of the production, and a decision within 20 working days. All the projects and all the documents are submitted to our National Film Institute. Some figures and some examples of Indian productions funded by the cash rebate. We had War, Mamadou 2, Yudra, but we also have some Indian projects filmed in Portugal without cash rebate, for example, the Imtiaz Ali, some Imtiaz Ali films that were filmed in Portugal, so are also filmed there. Regarding the scouting program, the scouting program is a useful program also. It's a tailor-made scouting visit for foreign production companies potentially interested in shooting in Portugal. So it's another good reason to film in Portugal and to search for our country. And we are also able to offer other funds offered and managed by our National Film Institute, the Portuguese Minority Co-Production Scheme, with an annual budget of 1.2 million euros for fiction documentaries and animation feature films, animation short films, but only in with official co-production. But I would like to remember you that the co-production treaty between Portugal and India was already signed in the last year, so official co-productions are allowed between Portugal and Indian production companies. The Portuguese-speaking countries co-production scheme with an annual budget of 500,000 euros for fiction documentaries and animation feature films, animation short films, bilateral funds with Portugal and France, Portugal and Italy, and Portugal and Luxembourg. And we are also members of the Creative Europe Media Program, Eurimage Fund, Ibermedia Fund. And as I mentioned before, we have these two Portuguese banks, Caixa Geral de Depósitos and BCP, Banco Comercial Português, that offer special credit lines for cultural and creative SMEs. I'm rushing to the end of my presentation, but to share with you some topics of the Portugal Film Commission's activity during 2020. So we were present in these markets and of course in also these media providers. So we would be more than happy to, and I'm totally available to answer all the questions you may have. So thank you so much for your attention. And please don't forget to follow us through our social media, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and of course, through our website, portugalfilmcommission.com. Thank you so much.
Obrigado, Manuel. You forgot to mention the 12th reason to visit Portugal. Yes, Cristiano Ronaldo. Portugal beckons the Indian filmmaker for many, many reasons and more. I shall now request Mr. Harshad Bhagwat to moderate and put to our teams from the Philippines and Portugal the questions you have sent in. Back to you, Harshad.
Thank you, Hugo. There's one very interesting thing, Manuel, that you mentioned, that last time you and Philippines presented together was at Berlinale, if I heard it correct. So I think we are in a good company today.
Sure.
I'm just going to start with the assortment of questions that I have received. Some of them are comments, some of them are questions. So I'm just going to start shooting. There is Mr. Shashank Bhatnagar from KS Storytellers. He is requested for a complete incentive guide of Philippines, which we will provide to you. In fact, I would like to announce that once the program is over, within a day or two, all those people who have attended today's event will get a complete list of all the speakers with their contact details. So you can get in touch with them directly for any of your requests offline. But we'll make sure that, Shashank, you get the complete incentive guide from Philippines. The next question is from Mr. Shaju from Pritish Nandi Communications. There is a query for a film shoot, and they are looking for a vineyard for a web series. So either of your countries can answer if you have vineyards available for film shoots in your country. Manuel, would you like to go for that?
Yes. As far as I understood, the question is if it's eligible for the cash rebate to a web series, right?
Do you have vineyards where they can shoot?
Vineyards. Yes, yes. Especially in the north of Portugal, even in the south, all around the country, we have several. So please feel free to contact us We will be more than happy to share with you some possibilities for that location.
I'll let you know, madam.
These are any vineyards in Philippines that we are not aware
of? I wish we have vineyards, but if you can reframe your location in strawberry fields, we have that. We have in the uppermost part of the Philippines, it's in Baguio. It's one of the coldest parts of the Philippines, and we have strawberry fields, but we don't have vineyards. We love Portugal, so yes, we recommend Portugal.
Thank you, Lisa. Thank you from our side.
Okay. Thank you, Marcus, for this.
Next question actually goes to both the countries. Everybody wants to know, once we travel to your country, what are the quarantine norms? How many tests you have to take? And, you know, do you have to stay in the hotels for like X number of days? So these are the questions that are bothering everyone. So either of you can take, this question. Let's start with you, Lisa.
Yes, I'll answer that, because right now that's exactly what we're doing with all of the foreign productions shooting in the country. So the current quarantine policy in the Philippines is once you arrive, if you first you go through the FDCP to apply your project to be so that we can assist you in getting an exemption, because of course, you know, it's very unpredictable, essential, non-essential travel. So it's best to go through the FDCP through our flex desk. So what we do is we assess your inquiry. What do you need connections with different local government in terms of your shoot, or you just really want to get support for entry? So for this, we help represent the project to the IATF. The IATF is our interagency task force for all COVID-related policies. And they meet once a week, and we present the protocols that and the safety plan that the production has in place. And we seek for their permission. So that gives you a travel exemption and allows you to enter the Philippines. So once you enter the Philippines, you are subjected to our quarantine protocols. Within 20, from arrival to the hotel, you are going to be staying in a hotel. It's a accredited quarantine hotel for all arriving foreign nationals. Stay there for 7 days. On the sixth day, you will get your swabbing, your RT-PCR. And then if you get a negative result, you'll go straight from the quarantine hotel to your hotel to finish the rest of your 14-day quarantine. And only until then, you're going to travel to whichever destination in the Philippines you're going to. From there, we also assist the production in securing local permits from those local government. Like, for example, you want to go to Boracay from Manila. We assist the production in securing all of the travel passes and permits. So it's going to be a smooth production for a smooth process for each production. Once you get to that destination, then it's very clear right now in our filming permits that that particular municipality or city will take responsibility over monitoring the compliance of the production with the current city's COVID-19 protocols and restrictions for filming. We also have right now a government, it's called a joint administrative order. It's a safe filming manual that guides all of the productions to understand what needs to be observed in the Philippines when you conduct your production shoots.
Manuel, your answer to the same question?
Yes. First of all, let me warn you that in Portugal, every 2 weeks, all the rules are revised and all the rules can changed. In fact, this morning we have new rules until Sunday, and then we will probably have different rules or the same rules. You never know for the next 2 weeks. First of all, only essential travels are allowed. Travel for professional reasons is an essential reason. So when you are requiring your visa at the Portuguese consulate, you should prove that you are traveling for professional reasons and for essential reasons. And then all the process is analyzed in the consulate, and only after that you will have the visa to travel to Portugal.
Okay, moving on. Lisa, there is a comment from Mr. Hemant Goenka, who is from Philippines and who's joined us today, regarding the vineyard question. He's saying that there is a native Bagne wine in Nueva Ecija, the island of Luzon, Philippines.
Oh, Nueva Ecija.
Okay. So there is a vineyard in Philippines.
Oh, wonderful.
We also have strawberry fields. Just kidding.
Okay, our next question is for Portugal from Mr. Manish Goswami from Siddhant Cinevision. He wants to know, is there a single window clearance? Does the rebate apply on the hotels and the airlines? And do web series or a music video come into the rebate as well?
Web series, yes. It's like, for example, a VOD project. Video clips, it's not eligible for the rebate. The requirements to have access to the cash rebate it's that you should spend qualified Portuguese production expenses of a minimum of €500,000 in Portugal. As far as the when we are talking about the web series, if you are talking about video on demand broadcasts, it's total eligible. As far as the platform has some editorial opinion on the projects. For example, if you are going to broadcast or to release your own series in your own website, for example, of course that it's not eligible. But if it's there are other platforms, for example, the regular big VOD platforms, as Netflix, Hulu, Amazon, whatever, of course that it's eligible to for the cash rebate. Yes.
Okay. Our next question is more of a clarification that we require you from Lisa, from Mr. Uden Rathod. He wants to know if the cap of 10 million is in Philippines currency or US dollars.
Agath, you want to answer?
The cap of 10 million is in Filipino pesos. So the maximum amount that you can for now avail for either the FLIP program, so the 20% cash rebate, or the international co-production fund, is 10 million Filipino pesos, so approximately $200,000. But that's for now, so you should. We will keep you posted because Chialisa is working a lot to have this cap removed, for example. So this is probably going to change and move in the next coming years.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully this year, it's actually already in Congress that we are appealing for the institutionalization of the Film Philippines Act, which allows for an automatic incentive of the 20% cash rebate and cap, still with a minimum spend of only 8 million pesos or around $192,000 in the Philippines in order for you to already activate the cash rebate.
Okay, our last question of the session, which actually goes to both of you, it's from Dipti Jindal. She's from Sajid Najarwala Productions. She wants to quickly she wants you to quickly explain the visa process in just few sentences, if that's possible, and how long it takes to get the visa. Lisa, would you like to go?
Oh, in the Philippines is actually a special working permits that we process. It's done through with your line production companies, and it normally just takes even less than a month. FDCP endorses your production so that the Bureau of Immigration will expedite. What the Flex offers, which is what we explained to you, the Film Location Engagement Desk, this is a one-stop single window application process of the FDCP Film Philippines, and we are in contact. It's a back end channel of the FDCP with the rest of the government agencies for all of your requirements, so permits, clearances, or visas.
Well, in our case, of course, that first of all, let me also share with you that the Portugal Film Commission are in a very close cooperation with here in Portugal, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, who managed all the network of consulates of Portugal abroad. Of course, that this cooperation is very useful for us. Please feel free to get to keep in touch with us and to explain and to explain your projects and to share your doubts. But of course, we know that the work of our consulates now is very busy. And of course, you must ask and you must require a visa for essential reasons, for professional reasons. Feel free to contact the Portugal Film Commission. And as I said, we have our focal point in Foreign Affairs Ministry. We are also in close cooperation with our tourism team in India, which is also a great help, so feel free to share and to explain your doubts, and we try to guidance to give you the best guidance that we can.
Arshad, let me just add that the reason why special working permits is the ones that we process is because you can actually enter the Philippines without a visa. The only time that you apply for a tourist visa is if you want to extend your stay for 60 days. Now, if you're working, then that's the special working permit that we help and assist to process.
Okay. Thank you, Lisa. Thank you, Manuel. I still have a few more questions coming in, but I was told that we are running 10 minutes behind schedule. So I would request you to take these questions directly to the film commissioners post the event. We'll be sharing their details with you in next day or two on your email. So back to you, Hugo.
Thank you, Harshad. Thank you to our teams from the Philippines and from Portugal. We shall now jump right into the second section of the day, which is a production showcase, where you will hear from the experiences of line producers from two very diverse countries. I'd like to once again remind you to keep your questions coming in the chat box, and we shall compile and field them to our panelists of both presentations once they are through. We're going to have a lucky draw, as I had mentioned earlier. At the end of today's program, we have exciting staycation vouchers from our hospitality partner, Taj Hotels, and their stunning new property in Santa Cruz, Mumbai. All members of the film fraternity from India who are present at the end of this webinar will qualify for this lucky draw. So hold on to your chairs, and it's time for production showcase. Our next presenter is from a country situated on the Earth's equator. Vast savannas peppered with immense herds of wildlife, snow-capped equatorial mountains, traditional peoples who bring soul and color to the earth. Welcome to Kenya. An English explorer once said, "The only man I envy is a man who has not yet been to Africa, for he has so much to look forward to." And we have a lot to look forward to from our next presenter, Blue Sky Films Africa. Blue Sky Films is a Kenyan company that has been facilitating and producing outstanding films and television shows throughout East Africa and Central Africa for over 20 years with milestone films such as, to mention just one, Tomb Raider 2, Lara Croft, to their credit. Blue Sky Films is represented by the executive producer, Mr. Jim Shamoon, and Mr. Hemal Shah, the head of production. Over to Mr. Hemal Shah of Blue Sky Films. Over to you, Hemal.
We'd like to welcome everyone on this webinar, and we'd like to thank FFTC for organizing this webinar for us. I'm just going to share my screen now. Yeah. So we represent Kenya, which is Africa's leading film destination in Africa. Kenya offers breathtaking locations, great weather all year round, friendly people, diverse cast, international equipment, rental houses, highly experienced crew, and developed transport and communication infrastructure. It is comparatively cheap to shoot in Kenya to most parts of Africa and offer the best value for your production. There are daily flights into Kenya from India. Visa process is simple and a wide variety of accommodation of various budget options are available. Kenya has been a popular choice of foreign productions for easy to obtain film licenses, work permits, and cooperative government support for productions of all scales of budget. Kenya offers a diversity of locations, and a variety of all parts of Africa are found in Kenya, from modern African urban cities to rural towns to Arabic-influenced architecture to indigenous tribal villages, the great African savanna, picturesque sandy beaches and turquoise waters, expensive deserts, dry salt plains, lakes, mountain ranges with snow-capped peaks, rich green earth, tropical Amazonian forests, rolling foothills, farmlands, and with the most incredible African wildlife only found in the region. This is some of our wildlife that you can find in various parts of our country. This is all the savanna grasslands scattered all across the country. Same savanna grasslands. Some of the mountains and waterfalls that we have in the country. Hills, tropical rainforests that we have across the country. Deserts, semi-arid areas. We have dry salt lakes across the country also. We have beaches, white sandy beaches, and we have warm weather, warm water all throughout the year. We have good resorts at the beaches, cities. Old cities and forts. Local tribesmen, local settlements, villages, all those kind of things that we can get over here. We have a lot of tea plantations, coffee plantations. Agriculture is quite big in this country. Crew. There's a large pool of crew that have worked on international films over the years. We can provide crews from directors, producers, DOPs, production staff, focus pullers, gaffers, key grips, electricians, DIT, chaperones, locations, costume designers, makeup, and many more support crew who have experience in all forms of the production. Cast. Kenya is an international hub and hosts a diversity of nationalities across the globe, from Caucasian, Asian, and African, and has the capability of providing a variety of authentic cast to fit any brief. Equipment. We have partnered with local and international equipment rental houses that pride themselves with being up to date with the latest technologies from digital to high definition broadcast solutions. However, if you'd like to bring your own equipment, we're able to facilitate speedy temporary importation. Lighting and grip equipment is readily available. Several cameras are also readily available, like the Alexa Mini, Red, Sony Venuses, all those. Government support and permissions. Through the support of government, filming has become easier. Work permits, film licenses, and all other documents needed for filming have been made easier to acquire by the support of the Kenyan government has extended to our sector. Incentive. We are one of the few film companies that is exempt from paying 16% value added tax, which means a bit reduction in the production budget. Travel. There are daily flights from Nairobi to Mumbai. Flight time is 6 hours. Kenya Airways has a bubble agreement with the government of India for daily flights from Kenya to India and India to Kenya. COVID. Travelers arriving into Kenya have to have a negative PCR COVID test carried out 96 hours before arrival. Indian passport holders are exempt from quarantine in Kenya. We test all our crew for COVID-19 before the shoot and every week into filming. All measures as per Ministry of Health and Film Commission shall be adhered during the filming. Some of the Indian films that have been shot in Kenya. Some of the international films that have been shot in Kenya. We have done all kinds of films from Chinese to the French, to the Italians, to the Germans, to Hollywood. And we work on all types of budgets. These are our contact details. So if you have any inquiries for filming in Kenya or East Africa, we are hereby welcomed. Thank you.
Thank you to Mr. Hemal Shah and Blue Sky Films for bringing us the amazing repertoire of film production services that you offer. Our next presenter is from Portugal, but has left his well-defined footprints right across the globe. Aptly named All Around Globe, the person in question is Jayaprakash Rangarajan, professionally known as JP, an Indian entrepreneur and film producer whose work speaks for itself. Thank you. after a wonderful presentation from all around globe, I'll request JP to share a brief presentation on his company. JP?
Hi, everyone. Thank you very much for inviting us to participate in this wonderful program. Thanks, Arshad. Okay, so we are based out of four countries, and we mainly focus now in Portugal, and for various reasons. And that's our company across the globe. Yeah, thanks, Emma, for helping with the slide. So next one. Okay, so we focus on four different departments. So film, tourism and logistics, sports logistics, DMC and representation, and destination weddings. Okay, so we established in 2013. So we are an international production company based out of four countries. And the only company to achieve two consecutive movies in Portugal for the cash rebate up to 30%. Okay, so way back in 2013, we are the first company to take any Indian movie to Portugal, a movie called Balapu. It's a Telugu movie. And we are also experienced in handling large size movies like Doom 3, War, Baby. For example, War, movie War, we had like 1,000 people on set on a particular day. So we are basically a one-stop solution company. So whatever you need, your filming requirements, you can like approach us, and we will get you whatever the best negotiated cost. And there is something called a new system, which is a transparency accounting. So whoever wants to film in Portugal with us, so we will open an account in their name, and all the payments will be run through that particular account, so that you have 100% transparency in terms of your expenses and what you're going to benefit out of the cash rebate system. Yeah. So that's about movie War, which had a spend of close to 4 million euros in Portugal alone. And that is the first ever Indian movie to get the cash rebate achievement on whatever the rebate system which we introduced, and it's the most successful movie. And it's a South Indian movie called Manmadhudu 2. This is the second movie which got through to the cash rebate system. Currently we're working with Excel for their next movie, which is already approved by the ICA for the cash rebate. So those are some of the popular movies we have done across the globe, like Doom 3, Chris 3. We have done about 60 feature films running production across the globe. Okay, so we speak about visa. Like, let me be to be very particular with Portugal at the moment. Okay, so filming comes under the essential and professional service. So it's a very simple, straightforward process. So anybody needs visa, so we will take the responsibility of their expense and travel. Of course, with COVID restrictions, all the process and policies we will follow. It's a very simple, straightforward process. We can get the visa as per the Portuguese consulate norms. So we can get into the question and answer session if there is any questions to be asked. Thank you.
Thank you very much, JP. Yes, we will get directly into the question answer session. And I'm sure there are lots of questions that you have for our two production houses. That is Blue Sky Films and All Around Globe. Harshad, over to you.
Thank you, Hugo. I have a few questions here, but I would actually like to ask one of my questions to JP, which I've been meaning to ask. As your company name suggests, All Around Globe, you pretty much shot all over the world. So I want you to know the process when a filmmaker or a producer comes to you and tells you that I have this brief or I have this film. How do you go on about selecting a location for them?
So in because I'm from India, and we do have a lot of experience filming across the country. We make 1,000 movies a year. India makes 1,000 movies a year, almost 3 movies a day. So you have a variety of requirements coming across different languages, different tradition, different culture. So what one filmmaker looks for is like basic 4 different types of location background, like a brown or a blue or a white or a green. Yeah, so sea-based, mountain-based, desert-based, or like, you know, snow-based, or with modern structure, or a downtown, whatever. Like, you know, depends upon their storyline and script, they will look for locations such way. Luckily, in Portugal, we have all of them. You know, so depends upon whatever their script is. So we will fit into their requirement, and we will do a docket on based on their requirement before even they plan for their recce. So we try to match their requirement, and we have a detailed discussion with the director. So then he explains what is this idea, how he wanted to see the locations. So me and my colleague Dimant is here, CEO of All Around Low Portugal. So we've traveled extensively in Portugal, and we know most of the locations, and we will recommend them accordingly, and we make a proposal to them.
Thank you, JP. Our next question is from Mr. Amit Roy to Himal Shah. They are looking for a water body in Nairobi. I remember when I had visited Kenya a few years ago, we went to this beautiful lake called Lake Naivasha. But I'm not too sure whether it's near Nairobi. So is there a large water body where they can shoot in Nairobi?
No, not in Nairobi. We'll have to travel a little bit outside Nairobi. Lake Naivasha is like 1 hour away from Nairobi. But if you can send me more details, we have a good reference location pictures. Then we can show it to him, meaning Kenya is full of lakes. Lakes and rivers are all across the country.
If I may share our experience about Lake Naivasha, Hemal, I believe there is an island right in the middle of the lake with a very small access where animals can walk in. And it's
Crescent Island.
It is an island without any carnivorous animals. So you can actually walk along with the zebras and the giraffes and
wildebeests.
Yes. Yeah, okay. It's a very beautiful island. It's a crescent island you can access by road. And it's right on the lake shore. And there's a nice house also over there. And yes, you can meet all these animals. But it's only the wildebeest, zebra, giraffes over there, and buffaloes.
So can we shoot there?
Yes.
Okay. So our next question is for you, Hemal, again. This is from Mr. Manish Goswami. What about the security and insurance, and these are the kind of issues in Kenya? And is there any kind of rebate that is applicable?
Okay, I'll start with rebate. We don't have a rebate system, but it depends on project to project. Meaning there was a recent project that we did for a French Bond film. It has gone into the government to see if we can get some sort of rebate, but it depends from project to project. We are one of the companies that do not pay VAT at all, 16% on anything over here. So that makes a reduction in your budget directly. So that is what we have over here. In terms of security, Kenya is quite safe. All our productions, when we will travel out, we will have security in place depending upon where we are filming. Like, let's say if you're filming in a national park, we'll have rangers with us during the filming so that everything is controlled. If we are in the city, the local police will be with us, the local youth will be with us. So it is quite relatively secure and easy to maintain all of that. Yeah.
Thank you, Hemal. Our next question is actually a comment from Mr. K.K. Radhamohan. He's a very well-known producer from Hyderabad. And JP, he's complimenting you for your work that you've done with him in the past. So thank you, Mr. Radhamohan. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.
There was another question for Portugal, which I could not take in the previous question and answer. And that question was about quarantine. How many days of quarantine once you land in Portugal?
There is no quarantine. You will have to bring in a 72-hour report when you're traveling. In fact, I'm traveling tonight to Portugal. I'm in Delhi now, so I'll be in Lisbon tomorrow. So when you arrive, you need to submit your 72-hour quarantine report negative. Then you're straight on to your job. Basically, this depends on your category of visa you're getting and your category of travel which you're going to be doing. So as I mentioned, Portugal considers and we declare filming as an essential commodity. So definitely you will get a letter from embassy from our side that you are essential to travel. So this is while check-in, all the process which you follow this letter, then you arrive into the country. As you arrive the same afternoon, you go for your recce. There is no quarantine.
Okay. There's a small correction, JP. We got an official data from Film Federation of India, and they have told us that India produces around 2,000 films and not 1,000.
Oh, I'm sorry. I need to correct it. Sorry.
So the numbers are much more, but I don't know about last year, how many we produced. I think we'll wait for that data.
I will change in my presentation 2,000.
Okay, so I think we are at the end of this question answer round, and back to you, Hugo.
I just need to add one more. Sorry.
Yeah, please.
Over to you.
Okay, so the travel essential, what happens, you know, more than the policies and process, as an individual, we need to respect how to go about keeping ourselves safe during this travel. Yes, we fall under the essential commodity. We get through non-quarantine rules. We get through to the places where we wanted to visit. Everything is fine. But it's very, very important for us to maintain the social distancing, for us to be very careful. You know, please understand, people are spending a lot of money traveling in these times. Every COVID test costs a lot of money in Europe. And it's important for us to keep safety norms monitored, okay, through and through. Don't put more than 4 people or 5 people in a big van, like a 7-seater van. Try to understand how to go about it and just don't roam around everywhere. As soon as your work is done, go back to your hotel. Okay, so these are the stuff which I would request whoever is going out in these difficult times to keep yourself safe and achieve your goals. Thank you.
Thank you very much, JP. I think that was very good advice from someone with great experience. And yes, we need to look after ourselves and stay safe for ourselves and our families. Okay. We've got a poll, a very quick poll that we'd like to do. And very simple question. We've got multiple choices. Hemal, would you like to take us through that? Hemal Bhagwat.
Yeah. Hello. Yeah. So let me start off with the polls. Before we start off with the polls, please note that these polls are for the participants who are from India, who are joining us. It's not for the speakers and the panelists. So let me start the poll now. Okay. There we go. The first question, have you shot on an international location before? It's a simple yes or no question. Request everybody to choose either a yes or a no. The second question is how many international shoots do you have to your credit? It's either still new to the game, which is between 1 to 3. Have you been around for a while, 4 to 10? Been there, done that, 10 plus. Third question is, do you plan to shoot in a foreign location in the near future? A simple yes or no. Number four, the fourth question is, when are you planning your next international location shoot? In the next 3 months, in the next 3 to 6 months, or within 6 months to a year? The fifth question is a multiple choice question, which means you can answer more than one. Which of the following countries would you like to explore for your next foreign shoot? Is it Philippines, Portugal, or Kenya? The sixth question is, what are you planning to shoot in a foreign location? Is it a song sequence from a film? Is it a few important scenes from a film? Is it the whole feature film? Is it a web series, either in full or in part? Or is it in the others category, which could be an advertisement, a music video, etc.? And the last question is, what would be your top 3 criteria for selecting an international location? It's a multiple choice. We've given you many options. Please choose your top 3, either the script or the storyline, the production incentives and rebates, COVID-19 safety measures, flight connectivity, local line producer and resources, budgets and costs, exotic locations. The voting. I am going to stop the voting now. Please, all of you, please press the submit button. If you press the submit button, I am going to end the polls now. Okay, I'm going to end the poll now. Okay, so that was quick. Hugo, Harshad, would you like me to share the results of the poll quickly?
That would be nice.
Okay, so just quickly share the results on screen. Yes, so as all of you can see, have you shot on an international location before? Majority of people have shot on an international location before. That's great. And some of you who haven't are just waiting, I guess, for the lockdown rules to be revised so people can get cracking on international assignments. The second question is, how many international shoots you have to your credit? We've got quite an equal number between the 1 to 3 to 4 to 10 category. And of course, we've got some who've been there, done that. And there are some, almost 6 people who've done more than 10 international shoots internationally. The third question was, how do you plan to shoot in the foreign location in the near future? Only 4 people have said they're not looking at it in the near future. I'm presuming that's because of the current pandemic situation. Or maybe there isn't a script demand. The fourth question was, when are you planning to shoot? And a majority, more than 50% of voters have said it will be within 6 months to a year. Which of the following countries? So 83% of people are saying they want to look at Portugal to shoot. And we've got an equal divide also on Philippines and Kenya. What are you planning to shoot in a foreign location? I think it's pretty much either a web series or a few important scenes from a film. These are the two main requirements. However, there are quite a few who've said they're looking at filming the entire feature film as well. The seventh and last question was, what would be your top 3 criteria for selecting an international location? The first clear winner was production incentives and rebates. So Portugal, Philippines and Kenya, your production incentives and rebates is what is going to drive people. And after that, the second is, of course, the budgets and the cost. That is at a number 2, with script and storyline coming at a distant third. So these are the top 3 reasons to shoot, and these are our poll results. Thank you everybody for participating in the poll. I'm just going to stop sharing the results now. And okay. All right, over to you, Hugo.
Okay, thank you, Hewal. Okay. You know, when the whole country is thinking about exams and postponing exams, we did a very quick exam right there. And everybody came out with flying colors. Hemal, very good. I think you should join our education department and take us all the exams. Okay, as we move towards the last part of the program, I would like to thank all of you, our audience and delegates, for your overwhelming response and enthusiasm, which is going to be rewarded very soon with our exciting lucky draw. But before that, I'd like to introduce our hospitality partner, Taj Santa Cruz, the Indian Hotels Company, which operates a chain of luxury hotels under the world-famous Taj brand, needs no introduction. Their stunning new property in Santa Cruz, next to Mumbai's domestic terminal, is yet another example of the finest in hospitality and luxury that India has to offer. Let's take a look at this presentation by Taj Santa Cruz, which Hemal Bhagwat will also add to. Over to you, Hemal.
Okay, just quickly taking you through, this is the Taj Santa Cruz Mumbai, which is a hotel, as some of you know, which is at the terminal, pretty closer to the domestic terminal. that's what the hotel really looks like. That's the overall top view. And as all of you can see, there are really close views of the runway right from the hotel and through most of the rooms as well. So just some quick, that's the lobby of the hotel. That's the all-day dining on the left-hand side. It's a great atrium with, it's almost six-story high ceiling, which is a glass ceiling. So it makes for great views. As you can see on the right-hand side, there are meeting rooms with, you can actually see the planes taking off since its proximity to the runway. We've got a lovely pool side as well, which is an open-air pool side. And of course, the suites, like I said, already have the view of the runways. And they've got a fabulous presidential suite, which is a staggering 7,000 square feet of space, which is a lovely space, for a shoot. Could also be shown as a as somebody's grand home. So, yeah, that's some more views. And that's what we have from them. We've got an exciting staycation voucher. And we're going to have three lucky winners at the webinar. And you'll get a one-night voucher for two guests with a validity from 1st April to 20th September. And it includes a room, breakfast, and Wi-Fi. Okay, I am going to stop the screen sharing now. And we will go on to the raffle draw.
Hey, Himal. Well, guys, keep your fingers crossed because three of you are going to have three wonderful staycation vouchers courtesy Taj Santa Cruz. Emil, would you be yes. honored?
Okay, so this is my lucky owl. Hopefully, it's lucky for some as well. Miss Deepti Jindal.
Yay, thank you.
So that's Miss Deepti Jindal for one voucher. It's going out.
Deepti.
Congratulations, Deepti.
It looks like ladies' afternoon today.
Yes. It's all women power.
Is that because you're conducting it, Hemal?
Deepti was also the first one to join in today.
Oh, wow.
Oh, is it? Early lovely.
Punctuality.
Early bird. The early bird gets the one. Great. I'm going to put this on the side and go for our second one. We've got Miss Bela Mulchandani.
Hi, guys.
Bela, are you there?
Yes, yes.
Hi. Yeah, I can see you there.
I can't see her, sorry.
Bela Mulchandani.
Hi. Bela. Hi, Bela. Congratulations.
Thanks, guys. Thanks. Really good session. Thank you to everyone.
Thank you, and we hope you enjoy your staycation.
Thank you.
Since we've anyway have gone into another lockdown, so you might as well enjoy.
It's a great session, guys. It's really, really good to see after another year, another show, and somehow you all have managed to wave off the pandemic madness and still do this. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Bela. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Got one more to go, right, Hema?
Yeah, last one. And if this person's not there, then I'm taking it.
That means you're going to keep the lady.
Then you can give it to me, Hema.
Okay. KK Radha Mohan.
KK Radha Mohan.
Yeah, I'm here. Hi.
Yes, Mr. KK. Yes, we've got enough questions coming in from you as well, so.
Mr. Radha Mohan is from Hyderabad, so you can use it when you're coming to Mumbai next, sir.
Yeah, surely.
So, thank you, everyone. For that, please do enjoy your staycation vouchers. We will get them sent to you post the event. Going over to you, Hugo.
Thank you. Well, yes, we've got three winners of the staycation vouchers, but I think everyone who's been a part of this Locations Connect is a winner because you've got a lot of food for thought and you've got a lot to take away, and we've connected beautifully over this platform. All that's left now is to request Harshad Bhagwat to conclude and express his gratitude to those who have made this so very special. Harshad, over to you.
Thank you, Yugo. I think we are pretty much, you know, covered everything. I also thanked all the people that I had to in my earlier speech. So just once again, thank you everyone for joining in. This is a new venture for us, and all your support matters a lot to us. We look forward to the next session. We've been getting a lot of questions in terms of when is going to be the next Locations Connect Live. And we are looking at around first week of June to hold our next session. So hope I'll see you again once again at that time. And God bless and stay home, stay safe. I'll see you soon. Take care.